We're really proud of bringing back a Modern Warfare 3 favorite map, Resistance, which is called Occupation in our game. It's set in Paris.
That was so iconic to the Resistance movement.
Everybody, this is DK Dynamite, and today what I have for you guys is a video that I've been working on for the past couple of days. This is my comparison of the Resistance multiplayer map from Modern Warfare 3 to its remake here within World War 2, now known as Occupation. But when you think about it, DLC 1 for World War 2 is of course called the Resistance, so to not include the Resistance multiplayer map from Modern Warfare 3 is committing treason. You know, the map's exactly the same as it was before, but of course has this new Resistance theme to it that fits along with World War II setting in Paris, and of course completely goes along with some of the story we saw in the campaign. Now, I did something very similar with Black Ops 3's DLC season, where I would compare an original map to the remake in present time, include some nice transition shots, some nice kills from both of the maps, and so forth. So hopefully I'll be doing this sort of trend with each of the remakes we see throughout World War II's DLC season, and of course for Treyarch's next Call of Duty in 2018. But it does feel like it's been a while since I recorded a commentary for World War II multiplayer. It's a little bit weird because I just haven't felt this way about a Call of Duty before, where the community is so divided, so crippled, and honestly, dry as hell. You know, usually every year we have this dead period in a Call of Duty cycle where people are moving on to other games or talking about other things, but then they of course all come back. But it feels like with the launch of DLC 1 for World War 2, not a lot of people came back, and if they did, they just said the same thing they were saying when the game actually came out, that the game feels incomplete, shorthanded, it just doesn't feel like a lot of passion was put into the work that we're seeing from the development teams. And I'll of course be talking about the recent changes made to Sledgehammer Games in an upcoming video, because I think that's also a red flag that something very wrong has been happening over at Sledgehammer Games, and it may or may not affect their development on the next Call of Duty game. And honestly, it's looking like Sledgehammer might back out of this 3-year development cycle, and they could even be replaced by development teams like maybe High Moon Studios or Raven. Any other development team that has a passionate group of people who want to make a great Call of Duty. You know, it feels like a World War II, they kind of released the bare minimum. And maybe it was Activision's fault, but maybe it wasn't. We just don't know, but I'll be talking about that in an upcoming video. But we all know Overwatch came out during Black Ops 3 cycle, and people of course move on from Black Ops 3 to Overwatch, but I do think with a big release like DLC 5, aka Zombies Chronicles, you saw a lot of fucking people either coming back from games like Overwatch or other free-to-play games and consistently kept playing Black Ops 3 for months more. Or there were people who just kept playing Black Ops 3 ever since launch and were more than hyped to see a new DLC in 2016. And I thought that that was quite interesting because Infinite Warfare didn't perform so well. Black Ops 3 kind of held its weight over the course of 2016, and it essentially had a year 2. But we were all worried that Black Ops 3 was going to have a year 3. Not because I don't like Black Ops 3, it's actually one of my favorite Call of Duties of all time, but we needed something different. We got to give Black Ops 3 a rest, play something new, and just World War 2 didn't feel like it was a good replacement for a lot of gamers out there, including myself. I've been playing it consistently. I'm only about to hit Prestige 3 multiplayer. I don't play it too much. I do complete a lot of challenges in-game, unlock a lot of weapons, open some cool supply drops. I've recorded a lot of live gameplays here on my channel, including some new ones for the brand new multiplayer maps. I did some gun game on the new multiplayer maps as well. And I've been trying my best to stay consistent here on my channel, but the viewership just isn't there for World War II as it was with Black Ops 3. My best uploading year here on YouTube was definitely during Black Ops 3. I could admit, I'm one of those people that was very disappointed to see that we only got 3 new multiplayer maps with this map pack. And I was expecting 4 multiplayer maps, at least 2 new war maps, maybe a couple of weapons, and then a new zombies experience. If they wanted to throw in some other zombie game modes, that would have also been fantastic. But I just feel like either Activision or Sledgehammer, they're just releasing the bare minimum and calling it a day. I understand war, of course, takes lots of resources, so they had to kind of devote a little bit of time away from those traditional new multiplayer maps into a new war experience. I get that, but I just feel like they could have done more. Now, to move away from the Resistance map pack altogether, I just want to let you guys know, as a little bit of a disclaimer, I really wanted to get more footage of Resistance for Modern Warfare 3, but something terribly stupid happened just days after I recorded this free-for-all here for you guys. Now, my PS3 ended up losing power. Every time I turned it on, it would just lose power immediately. I wouldn't even have that red light indicating that it's off. It would completely just lose everything. I changed outlets, changed power cords, tried everything I could, but I did take it in to Best Buy, where they told me that it was definitely a power supply issue, but I would have to contact Sony. I contacted Sony, and luckily they're able to send me a box in which I can put the PS3 into and send it off to them for repair. Repair wasn't too expensive, and I'm definitely investing in getting that fixed so that I can keep recording these comparison videos for you guys over the course of World War II's DLC season, and most definitely for Treyarch's next Call of Duty as well, since I do assume they'll be doing some more remakes throughout their DLC season once again. But I wanted to get at least a dozen gameplays recorded of Resistance so I can truly just play around with different transitions from different shots of Occupation and with Resistance as well. But luckily, this free-for-all match ended up being just enough to compare it with my Occupation footage. And I did have a couple of minor clips from, I believe it was a Kill Confirmed or a Domination match as well. So I threw that in here to compare with Occupation without a doubt. Now, unfortunately, within the free-for-all here on Resistance, I had some terrible luck in which we had a guy hacking. He had an invisible hack where he was running up to everybody, knifing them, and you couldn't see him. I'll put footage on screen if you guys haven't seen it already, but you can't see the enemy who was killing me. I was actually in first place throughout that free-for-all on Resistance, and unfortunately, I lost because the fucking invisible hacker ended up killing everybody way too quickly. But other than that, definitely a fun match. I'm grateful for the footage that I did have to show you guys here along with Occupation. But thanks so much for watching. Let me know down below in the comments section, what did you guys think of this comparison? How much has Resistance changed now that we have a remake of it here within World War II? And did the first DLC live up to its hype? Did it keep players engaged in World War II all throughout DLC 1's life? That's if, of course, you're on the PlayStation 4. And did it even bring players back who might have left World War II after not being proud of what the game has become ever since launch? Let me know what you guys think. This is Manique Dynamite, and enjoy the rest of the gameplay. Peace.
Kill denied. Kill denied. Recon aircraft awaiting orders. Recon airborne. Kill confirmed. Fritz X bomb ready. Kill confirmed. Fritz X bomb mission underway. We'll be right back.